Let us continue our discussion on adjustments in final accounts. The items for consideration today are outstanding and prepaid expenses. Number one, outstanding expenses. Number two, prepaid expenses. What is the outstanding expenses? This is an expense related to the current accounting period, but it is not paid until the end of the year. Such expenses are called outstanding expenses. That outstanding expenses may be given either in the adjustment or in the trial balance. Depending upon the place where it is given, the treatment will differ. Let us examine. Here in the first instance, a trial balance, a part of trial balance is given, and the salary appeared in the trial balance on the debit column of rupees 10,000. It is given in the adjustment that outstanding salary is there and the amount outstanding is rupees 3,000. How these items will appear in the final accounts, namely profit and loss account and balance sheet. Here it is very clear that the outstanding salary appears outside the trial balance. That means this is an unrecorded event. In other words, we can say that this 10,000 does not include the outstanding of rupees 3,000. So, this 10,000 is the salary actually paid. But while drafting the P&L account, we have to take into consideration both paid and unpaid items. So, in the profit and loss account, we have to record 10,000 plus 3,000, that is 13,000. So we can write here two salaries, rupees 10,000, add outstanding 3,000, total 13,000 in the amount column. This is an item which is given in the adjustment. So, it is to be taken in yet another place. This is the amount payable, therefore it will be a liability to the business unit. Hence, it must be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. That is, salaries outstanding, rupees 3,000. Hence, whenever outstanding expense is given as an adjustment, it must be added to the concerned expense in the trading and profit and loss account and should be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. Then take the second instance. Here also, the very same information are given. Salary is rupees 10,000. In this case also, there is salary rupees 10,000. Then salary outstanding rupees 3,000. Here also, salary outstanding rupees 3,000. Then what is the difference? Here, the salary outstanding is given in the trial balance. But in the first instance, it is given as an adjustment. What is its meaning? If salary outstanding appeared in the trial balance, what is its meaning? This outstanding amount is already added to the concerned expense, namely salaries. That means this salary of rupees 10,000 includes this 3,000 also. Hence, no further addition is required in the profit and loss account. It can be directly transferred or it can be directly taken in the profit and loss account. That means here, P&L account to salaries rupees 10,000. Because this salaries includes this outstanding also. Why? Salary outstanding appeared in the trial balance. Hence, this can be directly transferred to P&L account. No need for adding further the salary outstanding. Then take the case of balance sheet. Balance sheet. This is the outstanding salary. Means that is payable. Therefore, it always represents a liability. Hence, it will appear on the liability side of the balance sheet. That is, salaries outstanding rupees 3000. This is given in the trial balance recorded event. So, no further treatment is required. It can be directly taken on the liability side of the balance sheet. Thus, we can conclude. Whenever the outstanding expense is given in the trial balance, that item need be taken only at one place, that is on the liability side of the balance sheet. The second item is prepaid expenses. What is its meaning? This is an expense which is paid during the current accounting period, but it does not relate to the current period. It is for the future period. Then, how it is to be dealt in the trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet? That also depends upon where that particular item appears. It may appear either in the adjustment or in the trial balance. Let us see the treatment of prepaid expenses whenever it is given as an adjustment and also whenever it is given in the trial balance. Take the first instance. Here the salaries prepaid is given as an adjustment. That means this item is not considered while preparing the trial balance. Hence, the amount of rupees 10,000 is without considering the prepaid of rupees 1,000. This is the total amount paid. Hence, what is the amount which is paid for the current accounting period? From the total of rupees 10,000, we have to subtract rupees 1,000 because it is paid for the future period. This 1,000 is included in the salaries. Why? This item is not at all recorded. Hence, the amount that can be debited in the P&L account is to salaries rupees 10,000 less prepaid rupees 1,000. Then the net figure is rupees 9,000. Here the salary which is given in the trial balance is rupees 10,000, out of which we have to subtract the salary prepaid which is given in the adjustment. The net figure rupees 9,000 that relates to the current accounting period should be taken in the profit and loss account. Then if any amount is paid in advance, actually that is an asset to the business organization. Therefore, it must be shown on the asset side of the balance sheet. That is prepaid salary. Prepaid salary rupees 1,000. We can conclude whenever any prepaid expense is given in the adjustment, it will appear at two places. First one, as a subtraction from the concerned expense in the profit and loss account, and also on the asset side of the balance sheet. Then take the second case. Here also two items are given, salaries and prepaid salary. But the prepaid salary is not given as an adjustment. It is given in the trial balance. That means prepaid is already recorded. Recorded means from the total salaries, they have already deducted the prepaid salary. So, the figure Rs. 10,000 is after deduction of prepaid salary of Rs. 2,000. Therefore, this 10,000 relates to the current accounting period. Therefore, it can be transferred to the profit and loss account as it is without any further subtraction. Then that means in the P&L account on the debit side, you can write two salaries, Rs. 10,000. Then, salaries prepaid is given in the trial balance, recorded item. The recorded item will appear only at one place where it is to be taken. Any prepaid expense represents asset. Therefore, it must be shown on the asset side of the balance sheet. That is prepaid salary, Rs. 2,000. Let me summarize today's discussion here. We have discussed the two items, namely outstanding expenses and prepaid expenses. So treatment, whenever outstanding expense is given in the adjustment, number one, it is to be added to the concerned expense in the trading and profit and loss account, and also it must be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. But whenever outstanding expense is given in trial balance, it should be shown only at one place, that is on the liability side of the balance sheet. And the second item, prepaid expenses. It may also be given in the adjustment or in the trial balance. If it is given in the adjustment, the treatment is, number one, it should be deducted from the concerned expense in the profit and loss account and should be shown as an asset on the asset side of the balance sheet. But whenever this prepaid expenses is given in the trial balance, it is to be taken only at one place, that is on the asset side of the balance sheet. First of the items that we can see in the coming sessions. Thank you.